Hi everyone, Jessica here from Australian Rotary Health. We're here today with Nick Croydon as part of Australian Rotary Health's partnership with QBD Books to lift the lid on mental illness in schools. During the month of October, QBD Books has a list of books that you can buy, where $2 from every purchase goes towards mental health research. Nick serves as CEO of QBD Books. He has 25 years of experience in many segments of the Australian and international retail, publishing and media industries, and is well versed in corporate finance, mergers and acquisitions, financial reporting and governance. Nick is a strong and experienced leader who has helped to modernise and grow the business from 54 to 79 stores, achieved online growth of over 100%, and secured an exclusive online and retail partnership with Australian Geographic. Not only does he have a strong grasp of the business, but he knows what drives our customers and understands what we can offer them. He also seeks to inspire and nurture the talent of the QBD team members to maximise their potential. Nick holds a Bachelor of Accountancy, Finance and Economics with honours and is a published author of children's books. So, Nick, you recently talked about conducting an experiment in your own family, reducing technology. Can you tell us a little bit more about that and how that went?
Yeah, I guess I get asked a lot about, yeah, how do we get the kids off the machines? You know, and we struggle as parents ourselves with that because, you know, children these days have just grown up with this technology and they see no problem in sitting on these games and screens all day long. But you know, we and lots of other research know there are problems with that. So constantly being harangued by the kids, we said to them one day, okay, you know, we're going to show you the issues. So we said, like, you know, from tomorrow, you can just play on the machines as much as you like, right? Whereas normally they get an hour a day at the weekends. So they, yeah. So of course the kids loved it, right? So they played and we brought them down for lunch and, you know, they were absolutely hyper over lunch and, you know, ate their food too quickly and ran back upstairs to get back on the machines. And then we went, once they'd had about, you know, 4 or 5 hours, we thought that was enough. And then we went to, you know, tell them time was up and, you know, and they were angry. Right. And their eyes were, you know, red and they were just completely absorbed in these games. And it took us, you know, the rest of the evening just to calm them down. And then, you know, the next day we said, okay, well, you know, today we're no machines, right? And we're gonna go out and went down the park and we went along the river and, you know, and we went cycling and we took the dog out and we chatted and, you know, we watched a movie. Right, so we gave them a movie and watched it as a family, and we had lunch together, and you know, and it was completely calm, right? And so we then said to them, like, do you see the difference between yesterday and today and how you're behaving? You know, yesterday you were argumentative because we told you no, you know, and you were abusive and running around, and then today, you know, you're calm and we've been enjoying the air. So it was kind of that simple, right? And then we say to them now, you know, when it gets, if they try and go beyond their hour, right, you know, no, because you know what's going to happen, you know? So that's what we did.
Yeah, well, that sounds like it was very effective for you. And yeah, very interesting experiment there. I guess we've long known that reading is a great escape that can have a positive impact, especially with managing stress. What do you recommend people read to relax?
Yeah, look, it really doesn't matter. I think it's whatever you like, right? So for some people, reading a crime novel or a romance novel or a historical fiction novel, you know, whatever genre you're into, and I do this myself, you know, it's a wonderful way to escape, you know, because all these authors are so talented that they, you know, they transport you into their world and you imagine what the characters might look like, and you can really kind of get engaged in the book, and that leads to the relaxation, which is why most people fall asleep when they read. But it could also be, you know, it could be a non-fiction book. It could be reading about history, or it could be reading a manga novel. It really doesn't matter. It's the process of being interested in something and reading, right, that lowers your blood pressure, lowers your heart rate, right, relaxes you, engages the brain without overloading it, right, and that's what causes the de-stressing.
Yeah, absolutely. And I guess at the moment, what kind of impact has mental health and seeking resources related to that have, you know, maybe affected QBD bookstores?
Yeah, so obviously it's different state by state. So yeah, I'm up here in Brisbane. We've been relatively free, right? And it's a big state, so people have been able to, you know, drive around, go on holidays. So up here, it's been less noticed. But then my team members in New South Wales and Victoria, you know, I think you're over 100 days now in New South Wales, and Victoria has been over 250 days, I believe, in the last 12 months. You know, that's a different, you know, scenario. So we've had to do a lot of contact with them. So my regional managers in those states are, you know, fully employed, even though they've not got any stores to visit. You know, we've told them to act as, you know, welfare sort of officers and keep in touch with their teams. We bring some of the team members into the store to help with our online delivery, just to keep them active, right, and engaged, and they love that, to actually go to work. And last week we had an award ceremony where we put on, we do it every year, but normally it's face to face. But this year we hired a hotel, and there was about 40 people from Queensland there, but we live streamed it to every store, so that every team member could watch it, and they really enjoyed it because, you know, it was exciting, and they got awards and they got recognized, and I think just investing the time to say hello and check that they're okay, they appreciate it, and it pays dividends for us.
Yeah, absolutely. And I guess just one more question: if you could go back in time and prepare yourself for what we've been going through now, what would be your message to your younger self?
I would say, live in Queensland, which is where I am, because that's or Tasmania. I would probably choose Tasmania because I love Tasmania, and make sure I look after my team members as much as I can in the states that have been doing it tough, and making sure I never run out of red wine.
Yeah, great advice. Well, thank you so much, Nick, for your time today. It's been a really great chat.
Okay, thank you very much, Jessica.
Thank you. You can support the Lift the Lid in Schools campaign this October by heading into QBD bookstores in-store or all online and buying a book from their list, where $2 from every purchase will be donated to fund children's mental health research.